specific gravity, underwater weight, dry matter content, starch content, I'm going to try to explain. Specific gravity is expressed in kilograms per cubic decimeter, 10 by 10 by 10 centimeters, or 1 liter. With water is this 1. But with some shapes, this is difficult to measure. With this weight, this may still be doable, but it can also be done differently. Now we go to underwater weight. And it's about displacement. This 5 kilogram weight naturally displaces much less than 5 liters of water. But what is the specific gravity? Now we weigh this 5 kilograms of iron underwater. It now weighs 4,295 grams. So it has moved 5,000 minus 4,295 is 705 cubic centimeters of water, and we immediately know the content of this weight. Now we have the formula. Specific gravity equals 5,000 divided by 5,000 minus underwater weight. In this case, 5,007 divided by 5,007 minus 4,295 equals specific gravity 7.1. Now let's go to the potato. Here we have 5 kilograms of potatoes that have an underwater weight of 455 grams. Then the specific gravity is 5000 divided by 5000 minus 455. Equals 1.1. The net content of these 5 kilograms of potatoes is therefore 5,000 minus 455 equals 4545 cubic centimeters. Dry matter content is the content that remains when all the moisture has evaporated from it under laboratory conditions. Fortunately, we have a formula for this. Dry matter is underwater weight times 0.0493 plus 1.95. In our case, 455 times 0.0493 plus 1.95 equals 24.39%. Starch content, we also have a formula for. And the water weight minus 70.3 times 0.04772. And our example is 18.36%. Fortunately, we have a table that contains everything. Thanks for watching.